Edward Banfield was an American political scientist, but he's had a strong influence on development economics. He was born in 1915 and passed away in 1999, and he spent most of his career at University of Chicago and Harvard. In 1958, he published a famous study of Sicily, one Sicilian town in particular called Monte Grano, and the book was about why Sicily had remained so poor, because at that time, and still to some extent today, Sicily was one of the very poorest parts of Western Europe. Banfield saw that the fundamental problems were those of culture. The book was titled The Moral Basis of a Backward Society, and for Banfield, the key plague in Sicily was what he called amoral familialism. He defined this hypothesis in the following way, quote, "Maximize the material short-run advantage of the nuclear family. Assume that all others will do likewise." And Banfield noted early in the book that in Monte Grano, there simply were no voluntary charities. In Banfield's view, it was this cultural attitude which kept Sicily poor and which was responsible for poverty in many different parts of the world. Let's now look in a little more detail at some of the key propositions behind this cultural propensity toward amoral familialism. Banfield offered a number of cultural descriptions. For instance, he said that in a society of amoral familialists, only officials will concern themselves with public affairs. That is, individuals would not be very public-spirited, but officials were paid to look after public affairs. For a private citizen to take a serious interest in a public problem will be regarded by the community as being abnormal or maybe even improper. Precisely because of this lack of community involvement in a society of amoral familialists, there are few checks on the power of public officials. Office holders in general do not identify with the missions or the purposes of their organizations. Sometimes they are corrupt, sometimes they are lazy, but in general they lack the sense of mission or calling, which would otherwise get them to do a very good job. The law is viewed as corrupt, and when people see no good reason to follow the law, they simply won't, and they won't even feel guilty about this. Banfield also wrote, and here I quote, "In a society of amoral familialists, the weak will favor a regime which will maintain order with a strong hand." In part, that's because a lot of the other sources of social order, such as the propensity to cooperate or public spiritedness, are simply very weak. And if anyone claims to be motivated by public spiritedness, they'll be viewed as a kind of liar or fraud. There won't really be leaders, and in a society of amoral familialists, abstract political principles simply won't have that much influence. There will be plenty of zero-sum or negative-sum thinking, and there will be very low levels of trust. And Banfield's descriptions of some of the cultural problems of some poorer societies resonates to this very day.